Let's walk through the steps for providing human subjects information and applications prepared using Grants.gov Workspace. Before jumping into the new PHS Human Subjects and Clinical Trials Information form, you must first complete the Human Subjects section of the R&R Other Project Information form. It includes basic questions about human subjects' involvement for the application as a whole. Information from this form populates fields in the new Human Subjects form and controls the behavior of that form. Once you have verified the Human Subjects section of the Other Project Information form is complete, you're ready to move on to the Human Subjects form. Clicking on the form name will allow you to view the form, but not complete it. Until Grants.gov releases their web form version of the form, you must use the download and upload actions to complete the form. When you download and open the form, you will see some basic header information about the form package and workspace, and the check for errors, save, and print buttons. Scroll down and you will find the data entry items. In the box at the top is the information populated from the R&R Other Project Information form. If you answered no to human subjects, you'd complete the If No to Human Subjects section and save the form. If you answered yes to human subjects, you will need to include at least one full or delayed onset study record. If entering one or more delayed onset studies, you would complete the requested information in the delayed onset study table and save the form. To add full study records, Workspace uses a feature called Manage Subforms, which is separate from this form. If your application only includes full study records, simply save the form without any data entry. Note that the Human Subjects form is in an in-progress status. Use the Upload action and follow the prompts to include the completed form in your application. To add a full study record, click Manage Subforms beneath the PHS Human Subjects and Clinical Trials Information form name. Click the Add Subform row button, and you'll be prompted for a subform name. Enter a name and click Save. Until Grants.gov releases their web form version of the study record subform, you must use the Download and Upload actions to complete each study record. These actions have the added benefit of allowing others to complete the study record form offline and return it to you to add to your application. So even when the web form is available, you may still want to use this feature. When you download and open the form, you will again see the basic header information about the form package and workspace, and the Save and Other buttons. Scroll down and you will find the full study record form. Note that when you download the study record subform, both the main form and the subform show an in-progress status. Use the Upload action and follow the prompts to include the completed study record form in your application. When you are done, you should see a past status for both the main form and the subform. And that's it.